Good morning, Eagle Nation. It's Friday. You've made it this far. You can make it to the end. It is 11-6-2020. Say to 1 a.m. wherever you may be, please stop, please stand, let us rise for this morning's Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated. I hope you're dressed for success today on this Friday. We have only a few short announcements coming your way. And it's also the end of the week in which all week long in PBIS, you've been focused on being responsible by turning in your assignments, using checklists to keep track of your assignments, asking your teacher to make sure you know how to turn in your assignments. So today, you get to celebrate your success for turning in those assignments. Reflect for a moment. Did you do a good job? Did you get lots of work turned in this week? Are you proud of the quality of the work that you've turned in? I hope that you are, and I hope that you do something today to celebrate your successes. It's important to celebrate those steps along the way. Looking ahead to next week, just some heads up. Wednesday is 11-11-20. It's Veterans Day. We celebrate all those who have served in the armed forces to protect us. And because of it, we have no school that day. That means then that the meal pickup will not be on Wednesday, but rather the day before, on the 10th. So be sure that if you need meal pickup, you come from 7 to 8 a.m. on Tuesday the 10th, or from 3 to 5 p.m. on Tuesday the 10th to do just that. Those are all the announcements we have today. Hello, Glamour. Let's get to some words of wisdom so you can get to the business of teaching and learning. Today, appropriately so, is on the topic of goals. When Evelyn Cisneros started the first grade in the early 1960s, she was the only Mexican-American in the entire school. She was very self-conscious because she felt so different from the rest. Her mother enrolled her in ballet, hoping she would overcome her shyness. Evelyn began to dream of becoming a ballerina. And when she was 18, her dream came true when she became a member of the San Francisco Ballet. In many ways, her life story can be summarized with this Persian proverb. Step by step, one can climb the stairs. By learning one step, one ballet step at a time, Evelyn Cisneros made her dream come true. Ask yourself this. What do I want for my future? Am I taking steps towards my dreams? With something to think about, this is Mr. Lodato. Make it a great day or not, the choice is yours. Oh, and please have your cameras on today, have your screens on today so that we can see you, so that you can learn the most, and so that the learning experience is improved for all of your classmates. It makes a difference. You make a difference. We'll see you in class.